Hi everyone, how do you do? You know, we have to divide PowerPoint into two different sections, before Morph and after Morph. When Microsoft introduced the Morph transition, it was a revolution for PowerPoint. Today I'm going to show you a simple but very beautiful transition in PowerPoint. Click on Layout and select Blank. I want to add a 3D shape to my slide, so from Insert tab, click on the 3D icon and search for a flower. You can see all the flowers. Select this one and click on Insert. Since it is a 3D model, I can easily rotate it to any direction. If you couldn't find your 3D model, I suggest you look for it on this website. The link is in the description. For example, if I search flower, I can see lots of 3D flowers. You can download the items that have download icon in the top corner for free. For example, I want to download this flower, so I click on download 3D model. In this window, you can download different formats, but the format that works for PowerPoint is GLB format, so you have to download that format. For bringing a 3D model to the PowerPoint, from Insert tab, click on 3D model and select this device. Or you can easily drag it to the slide. First, let's duplicate the model and cover the entire page with it. Draw a rectangle and change the color to this, and align it to the middle and center. Since I use align to the middle and center a lot, I have added them to the quick access toolbar. For adding an item to the quick access toolbar, you just need to right click on the tool and select add to quick access toolbar. Anyway, add a text box and set font size and font style like this, and select center alignment for text. Type in morph and align it to the middle and center as well. Select the rectangle and then hold the control key down, then select the morph text box. From shape format tab, click on merge shapes and select subtract. Remember, the order of selection is important. First, you have to select rectangle and then the text box, because we want to subtract the text from the rectangle. Anyway, select the shape and remove outline from it. Now add a flower to the slide and rotate it. Make 6 copies of it and cover the text with it. It is time to duplicate the slide. Change the rectangle color to green and rotate the flowers and arrange them like the shape. Select the rectangle and add a drop shadow to it. Click on the Format Shape button and increase the size of shadow and blur like this. Hold the Ctrl and Shift keys down and increase the rectangle size a little bit. Now select the Transition tab and select Morph. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, give it a big thumb up and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Alright, it was all for today's video. I'll see you next video.